am Miss Danielle. I feel like I've not been saying that a lot lately, but you need to know who I am. I am Miss Danielle, and I am pumped and ready for prime time. And I am dressed all in purple from my shirt to my tutu to my pants to my shoes. We're all purple today because purple is my favorite color. I even tried to get some purple in the lights today. Purple is my favorite color, and today is dress in your favorite color from head to toe. I did not have a hat that's purple, I know. Now I know what I need to invest in, a purple hat. So hopefully you are all dressed up in your favorite colors. Let me know what those favorite colors are. Send me their pictures. And if you are not, then pause right now and go get your favorite color on. Did you do it? Good. It doesn't matter if it's just a shirt. You can be not fun and just dress in one thing that has your favorite color on it. Or you can be super fun and dress in your whole outfit being your favorite color. I'm just kidding. You're fun either way. But I am super pumped and excited to worship with you guys, to hang out with you guys in primetime on YouTube today. I don't know why I have so much energy, but I have a lot of energy today. Do you have a lot of energy? If you don't, then do some jumping jacks right now, right now. Woo! Good job. Now you're ready to go. We have some songs that we're gonna sing. We're gonna praisercise. I feel like our new song, Your Love Is Like Wow, is a very good praisercising song. So we're gonna do that one, and we're gonna do another song. And are you guys ready? I'm so ready. Stand up on your feet, out of your seats, and let's get ready to worship.
Oh.
To start our story. However, first we need to talk about our word of the month. If you remember our word of the month, I want you to shout it out right now. If you said compassion, you are correct. And if you said compassion, what does compassion mean? Even if you didn't and you know what compassion means, shout it out right now. Hopefully you did. And you said that compassion is showing love by helping others and understanding what they're feeling. So if you see somebody cry and you're like, oh, they're feeling sad, I'm feeling sad for them, that is showing compassion. If you see somebody who has their arms full of things and you look at them and you're like, oh, I know what it's like to have my arms full of things and then you can't open the door, or then you're going to drop something and I feel so bad for them, so I'm going to go help them. That is showing compassion. Today, we're going to talk about how showing compassion is sometimes hard. Sometimes when we show compassion, we have to step outside of our comfort zone. Let me tell you what I mean. For this, you are all going to need a blanket, or maybe some pillows, or some stuffed animals, or things that make you happy and feel warm and comfortable and comfy. So I want you to pause this video, go get all of those things right now, and bring them to where you're watching me. Go. Do you have them? Good. I have a blanket with me, and what we're going to do is, if you have a blanket, you're going to just put it down on the floor. And if you have stuffed animals or pillows on with the blanket, you're going to put them around the edge of the blanket. If you just have pillows and stuffed animals, make like a square or a circle out of them. I'm going to show you what my comfy space looks like. Ready? So this is, I'm going to sit here in my comfy space on top of my blanket that's nice and soft. Athena's right there in my comfy space. This is my comfy space. So I want you to sit down or stand in your comfy space. Can you do that for me? I'm going to stand up in my comfy space. Good. We're all in our comfy space. We feel safe here, we feel comfortable here, and we feel ready for the day. But what happens when you step off of that blanket or out of the square or circle of stuffed animals and things
and pillows that you made, it's almost like it's not as safe, or it's not as comfy, right? We don't feel as comfortable as when we're here. My blanket's really soft and my feet are squishing into it and they feel really good. But when I step off of the blanket, it's not as soft, right? And sometimes when we step out of our comfy space, it can be a little scary. And when I say comfy space, I don't just mean that we're talking about the blanket or the stuffed animal circle we made. I'm talking about things that we do. When you have something new to try, sometimes it's hard to try those new things because it's scary. Or you've never done it before, so you don't know what it's like, and that seems weird, right? So we want to stay doing what we always do because that's what we know and it's not as scary. But sometimes showing compassion means that we have to step out of our comfy space, step out with me, and be maybe a little nervous or feel a little odd or weird or different. Sometimes when we show compassion, that's what we have to do. Go ahead, step back into your comfy space. We're going to start our story, and it has to do with comfy spaces and showing compassion. This story is about a woman named Ruth. Now, Ruth had this big family. She had her mom and her dad and her siblings who lived somewhere else, but then she also was married and she had a husband, and her husband had a brother, and then her brother had a wife, so she had a sister-in-law, and she had a mother-in-law and a father-in-law, like her husband had a mom and a dad, and she hung out with that family all the time. She lived with them, she stayed with them. That was becoming part of her comfy space, and she had comfy space that was at home with her parents and her siblings. Now, sad things happened to Ruth because all in the same year, her father-in-law died, her husband died, and her husband's brother died. That's a lot to deal with. That's a lot of sadness and a lot of hurt. And so it was her and her mother-in-law and her sister-in-law, and they were all just feeling very, very sad. And this is what happened. Naomi, who is Ruth's mother-in-law, turned to her two daughter-in-laws and said, "Guys, I am feeling so sad for you and with you. I think that you guys need to go home back to your families where you're safe and where you're comfortable." If Naomi is sending her daughter-in-laws away and she just lost her son and husbands, do you think that she's standing in her comfort zone or out of her comfort zone? Out of her comfort zone, right? Jump out of your comfort zone. Naomi is showing compassion and love. She's thinking about her daughter-in-laws by sending them away to their families, to their comfort zones. But sending them to their comfort zones means that she is out of her comfort zone. Go ahead, step back in. When the daughter-in-laws heard Naomi say this, they were filled with sadness and they didn't want to leave her. But Naomi insisted that they leave her. She told them, go back to your families. What am I going to offer you?" She didn't feel like she had anything to offer them because she was just her by herself. So Ruth's sister-in-law decided to go back to her family, but Ruth, she stayed. She told Naomi that, "I am not going to leave you. You lost more than I've lost. And where you go, I'll go. Where you live, I'll live. Your people will be my people." How cool is that? Do you think that it would be a comfort space for Naomi to go back home? Probably. That's where her mom and dad live and her siblings, right? That would be where she would be most comfortable. But she was willing to do something new, to go on a different adventure, out of her comfort zone, step out of your comfort zone, go ahead, just to show compassion to Naomi. She was willing to change her plans, to do something different, to do something maybe even a little scary because it was new and she didn't know what it was going to bring, just to show love and compassion to Naomi. Go ahead, step back in your comfort zone. Just like Ruth showed compassion to Naomi by stepping out of her comfort zone, we can do the same thing. Sometimes it might be something a little bit easier. Maybe just saying hi and giving a smile to somebody that you don't know. Somebody at a store or in your neighborhood. That could be hard, right? It's sometimes scary to smile and say hi to people we don't know. But if you pass them and do it, you're stepping out of your comfort zone and you're showing them love, you're showing them compassion. Let's step back in. What if your family wants to go on vacation somewhere new? Maybe your brother and your sister pick the spot. It's a new city, or it's a beach and you've never been to the beach, or it's it's camping and you've never been camping, but that's what your brother and your sister want to do. Will you go out of your comfort zone, step on out, to show compassion for the rest of your family? You know that it's something that they want to do, someplace that they want to go. Will you go there because you love them and you want to try new things with them? Go back into your comfort zone. All of those things can be kind of scary, but when we go out of our comfort zone to show compassion, it almost always turns into something amazing and great and awesome. So next time you think you should show compassion, but you're a little nervous or you're scared to, be like Ruth. Jump out of your compassion, your comfy zone. Go jump out. And show compassion to the people around you. Jump back in. While we're in our comfy zone, we're going to pray, because when things get scary or tough or hard or confusing, we always know that we can focus on God, because He shows us compassion every single day. He knows what we're feeling and He can help us through it. So let's do that right now. We're going to pray. Let's see, what should we do? We're in our comfy zones. So why don't we tuck ourselves into a ball in our comfy zones? Ready? Okay. I'm in my comfy zone. I'm tucked into a little tiny ball. Are you guys ready to pray? Let's do it. God, we thank you so much for being with us every single day, for helping us when we get nervous or when we're scared, and for keeping us safe and for keeping us healthy. Please help to remind us that you are always with us when we need to jump out of our comfy zone to show compassion to someone else. Remind us of Ruth, and how we can show somebody our love and for them and our compassion for them by doing something that we wouldn't normally do for them. Please continue to be with us. Keep us safe and keep us healthy. We love you so much. In your name we pray. Everybody said, amen. All right, do you guys want to do an activity? Let's do it. For your activity, I am still in my comfy zone, because you are going to need your comfy zone, so don't tear it down. Here's what you're going to do. You're going to need your comfy zone, you're going to need at least two players, you and somebody else, and you're going to need 10 small things. They could be 10 Legos, it could be 10 cotton balls, it could be 10 popsicle sticks, 10 of something, 10 beads, whatever you choose. Now here's what you're going to do. You're going to set your comfy zone across the room from your second player's comfy zone. So you both have your comfy zones, you'll sit inside of them, and you each get 5 of those small things. So whatever you chose, I'll just say that we picked cotton balls. So I would get 5 cotton balls, and the person who's playing with me is going to get 5 cotton balls, all inside of our comfy zone. Now, your job is to get all of the cotton balls into the other person's comfy zone, right? We're showing compassion, so we're giving things to our friends. So you're going to get all of your cotton balls need to go to the other person's comfy zone, but not just all of your cotton balls, any cotton balls that are inside your comfy zone. The winner is going to be the first person to get rid of all of the cotton balls in their comfy zone. Now, here's the deal. As you're stepping out of your comfort zone to give your cotton balls to the other person, they're doing the same thing to give cotton balls to you. So you still have to get rid of all of your cotton balls. And you can only do one cotton ball at a time. You cannot pick up all of your cotton balls and just throw them into the other person's comfy zone. You have to do one at a time. If you want to make this harder, use a spoon to carry the cotton balls across, or the Legos across, or the beads across. Use a spoon or something that can carry it across. And if you drop it, then you can only touch it with that thing, the spoon or whatever you're using. That'll make it even harder. Are you ready to play this amazing game? Are you ready to step out of your comfort zone to give compassion to the player sitting across from you? I think you're ready. I hope you have fun with this activity, and I will talk to you more about compassion next week. Bye, guys. Popping in from my comfort zone real quick, I forgot to tell you, next week is Wear Your Favorite Sports Team's Colors. So it could be a football team, a professional football team, or hockey team, or baseball team, or it could be a school team, a college team, whatever you want. Deck yourself out in their colors, in their gear. Have fun with it. All right. See you next week.